Hello, this is Paul from Foresight Tech. In this lecture, we're going to deal with some properties for uniform distribution. And the measure is the mean, standard deviation, of course, the variance. here, I show you directly for the formula. If x is followed for uniform distribution from A to B, and the mean, remember we use mu, right, is half of the sum A and B, okay, which means what is the midpoint for AB, okay, or the average of AB. What is the standard deviation sigma? Sigma is this fraction B minus A over square root of 12. Okay, so look at 12 is very strange, right? Standard mean tells you the expected value or the average or the center, remember? Standard deviation tells you the spread of your distribution, okay? And or the variance of your distribution, or the variant of your distribution. What is the variance? Which is the square of the standard deviation, right? We have all this definition before. So square of sigma goes to the top square, the bottom square, which is B minus A square on the top. The bottom is 12, square of 12, square root of 12, which is 12. Okay, and then we're going to deal with these two images. We just say this is the average. If we draw a graph, you can see it clearly. If this is the PDF, okay, the probability density functions for the uniform distribution, see, is a big rectangle, right? And the where, I mean, all the value is 4 between A and B. What is the expected value or the mean or the average, which is the exact average of A and B, right? The average of A and B, or the center or the middle point of A and B. So this is meaningful. for this, we need to do calculation to find. Okay, what is the calculation? I show you very basic proof here. Just show you the definition means. Okay, what is the definition for mu? In continuous random variable case, okay, remember for the discrete random variable we defined before, right? If mu is sigma summation x times the probability, okay, so here is a continuous case which is different, okay? The summation is for discrete. If we're going to continuous, we cannot do summation because of infinite numbers, okay? So how do you do? Okay, it's integration. So we use this integration. You don't know this yet probably because if you did not go to calculus, okay, if in the future you go to calculus, definitely you know this is integration, okay? It's a kind of limit of summation, okay? It's very similar. Everyone look at it, it's very similar. Just the notation changed, the method of calculation changed, okay? So still x, the value times the, of course, this is not the probability, but it was still called the density function, the PDF, right? So times x times PDF, okay? And there is due summation, here is due integration. And then you do calculation, you finally, from the calculus, you'll find it's half of A plus B. Okay, so we look at another, it's sigma. Do you remember sigma? Here, look at this box. So here is the definition of sigma, standard deviation in discrete case, which means x minus mu and the square times px, right? Still the probability functions. Can we see the distribution function? Or we say the PDF, right? Okay, and then if we move to what? If we move to the continuous case, see the sigma summation goes to integration. Okay, and this dx minus mu square PDF. Okay, it's almost the same. And here you do calculation. Now you skip. Okay, you can skip how to do calculation. And this is just you use the similarity. I mean, so what? We finally get it. The meaning is very similar as a discrete case. So what is the meaning for the mean? Average. Okay, what is standard deviation? Tells you how spread of your data. This line is not a data. This time is the distribution. Okay, how spread? I have two questions to show you how to do calculation. We all directly use the formula we learned. So first, look at this example. We showed a lot of times. the age of the customer for the uniform distribution from 15 to 17. If this is scatter X, everyone you already know X for the uniform distribution, right? So what the average? Average age, average is the mean, right? So I mean, so if we set up, that's all you need. If we set up this X, so X, if X is the age, okay, then X follow uniform distribution from this is A, right, 15 to this is a B, 75. The minimum age is the maximum age, okay. The first setup, the second what the question. The question is here. Okay. The question is to find the mu. The question is to find the mu, right? What is mu? Okay, it's up here. Now we have a formula. Mu is just do you remember the formula is A plus B over 2. Where is A? This is A. This is B. Or we say this is A. This is a B, right? Okay, so definitely. So now you do calculation is what? Is 15 plus 75 over 2. What do we get? This is 80, 90, right? 90 over 2 is 45. Means the average age of all the customers based on the theory should be 45 years old. So 45 years old, right? Okay, so did the first. The second questions. So now we directly have the formula. Okay, is directly have the distribution. X is a random variable follow uniform distribution. You know, this is A, right? The minimum. This is a B, the maximum. And the questions ask you standard deviation. You remember standard deviation sigma. And the variance is sigma square, right? Okay, so all we need to do is use the formula. From the formula, so sigma is what? Do you remember the definition? The sigma is, here is B and minus A, and then over square root of 12, okay? That's the formula we need, and then we do calculation. How many do we have? So here is 80 for B. 20 for A over square root of 12. Okay, definitely we get 60 over square root of 12. And you do calculation. Okay, let me see. I did the calculation, so I get around, okay. This is around 17.32. Okay, this is the first for sigma. The second, what is sigma square? Sigma square, you can do this, okay? So sigma square, you either do directly use sigma is 17.32 square, okay? And then you do square, let me see, I get 299.98, this is around, okay? Around, see? You can directly use these results, or you can do this. Or you can do sigma square, use the formula, it is square, which means B minus A square over this square goes to 12, remember this? Or you can do this. If we're going to do this is B is 80 minus A 20 and they put a square and then square. Okay, you do calculation. So you should get the same. Okay, at least around the same. Okay. That's all. Thank you.